Let's look at a few properties of the convolution method. One property is that basically a convolution output, the process of convoluting an image, basically means that it's linear and shift invariant. What that primarily means is that it's the same everywhere. The value of the output depends on the pattern in the image neighborhood, not the position of the neighborhood. So basically, it doesn't matter how we apply it, it always will come up with the same answer. And that's an important part of it. It doesn't matter how much you shift the image. Another property that's extremely valuable is the commutative nature of convolution. That means that I can apply F and G in this order, or I can flip it and apply G and F in this order. It's also associative, which basically means that first I can do a convolution of F and G and then convolve with H, or I can change the order and do a convolution of G and H before, and afterwards I can do a convolution with an F. Another property, and I think we've experimented with this already, if you take an identity, a unit response, in this case shown by the simple thing, and if I actually do a convolution of a image with or a function with an identity, we get the original one back. Question for you folks to think about on the forums is that true for cross-correlation? I look forward to seeing you discuss that there. Just to kind of prove this point here, I take this kernel, or an image here, sorry, and this is my impulse. And now notice it's not symmetric. And if I just do a convolution with this, we will get the original one back. One more important feature to remember is that convolution is a separable process. That basically means is that we can actually do the convolution just by actually having a kernel that captures the rows, and then we can actually do it separately for the columns. So you can actually now allow you to separate out even kernels to have two different kernels. That is, one just has the rows and the columns themselves, and then we can actually, you know, run the process one by one. The best part of this is actually many computational advantages, including, of course, keeping a lot of less things in memory.